So I recommend that you have some sort of template that you work with that identifies key characteristics for your persona, not just talking about their demographic information, but other things like, who are they as people? Where do they work? How do they live? Do they have families? Do they travel a lot? Other things about them that helps you understand who they are as human beings. What kind of goals and tasks are they trying to achieve? What kind of fears and frustrations do they have about today's solutions or potential hacks that you think they do to derive a solution today? Quotes. It's always useful to have things that you would imagine they say about the problem that you're trying to solve. Any additional information that you provide about a persona that helps those who you're working with understand who they are as people will likely lead to a better solution down the road because you really understand who you're building it for. You typically don't want more than 2 to 3 persona types. More than that means you may have identified too complicated a process to try to solve right away. You want to have 1 or 2 primaries and potentially a couple of secondaries. Primaries are typically those who actually use the product, and secondaries could be someone who potentially is the buyer. So if you're building an application, say a business-to-business application that's going to be sold to a large company, the persona who uses the product versus maybe an HR department or finance department who buys the product could be 2 different personas. You might have a multi-sided market, in which case you have a couple different personas that you have to identify. A great example is a ride service where you have a driver persona and you may have a passenger persona. As soon as you see drift and you have too many people you're trying to solve for, it should be a signal that you're potentially going after something too complex and it may be time to narrow your scope.